bills do not rise to the level of constitutional importance. But let me finish my thought. In saying that they do not rise to the level of constitutional importance does not mean at all that there isn't always this urgency for us to continue to press on with ensuring equality among peoples, not just men and women, but in every respect. Okay, I appreciate your call. People, it ends with the people. So if the people vote no, that's the end of the matter. End of story.
Steve, how you doing?
Very good, thanks.
Well, you know, your boy was speaking on this one. And Article, Chapter 3 of the Constitution. Brother Clinton, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
It's a blessing from the light to have you on. And I was waiting to express Chapter 3 of our Constitution, Article 28, 3. And that is what you were speaking about in respect to, and Mike and Steve, what I was saying the other day, why they did not have to touch our Constitution. They can legislate these things. And so I just basically not going to waste no time, just want to say to the great gentleman in studio and encourage other great minds like him in that profession to step up to the light now. And the light is to bring these kind of knowledge to the owners, the inheritors, and the successors, and
yes,
those who are losing their homes, who lights are off. Young men are on the streets on every corner without a job.
Yes, truly.
Article 28, Mr. Maurice Clinton. I appreciate you bringing that. And Steve, just for point of information, the reason why I mention Article 28 of Chapter 3 of the Constitution is because, and Queen's Counsel, Mr. Clinton, said it correctly. You know, it's absolutely egregious for them to take, if you want to appeal a case, it used to be $25, now it's $500, and the average young Bahamian inheritor and successor is on the street without a job. Why, some foreigner, Mr. Clinton, I don't know him and he don't know me, and he don't know my brothers and sisters on the street and our struggle of 41 years of independence. I'm saying to the Bahamian people as the great-grandson of Elijah and Caroline Miller of the 1800s, and the grandson of Willis Miller, the president of the Atlas, Cricket Island, and Long Key People's Association. I just throw people in there, but it's the Atlas, Cricket Island, and Long Key Association. And in our Constitution, you will find, like Mr. Clinton will agree, and Steve will agree, and anyone who has read it, I'm a high school dropout and I read it. And listen, you will find the power of association. We must now form the association against number two, the first one called Majority Rule. And then we now
Okay.
Both of independence. Steve, I thank you for
your
time.
I
your great listeners, God bless. The light is with us.
Amen. Okay. And let me say this to you out there. I am not a QC, and I am not
as, to be a QC. We know the
story. I am not as successful as I would have liked, but that is because of other circumstances. And the only reason why I'm a little bit more successful at some of these matters than the others is because the others don't often, if at all, find themselves into court.
Yeah, they have never really went to court mostly on these kinds of cases. I said this yesterday. Some people may have thought that I was being insulting to anybody, but no, not at all. It's a statement of fact. They have not. They say we reside all of our faith in you. Get this done. But there are other people in this country, like Maurice Clinton, who have been at every level and.